Hey there, Capricorn. Welcome to your reading for the week of November 27th. This week, we're going to jump right in here. You have this letting go card and this purification card. I do feel you're finally letting go of something. It could be anything. It doesn't have to be love. It could be something toxic, although, this is just your energy, the devil. So again, I don't look at the devil as bad or good. To me, it can be toxic, but it could also just be you showing up in the reading. And again, this does not have to be a bad thing. So I kind of feel, I feel like you're letting go of someone or something, and probably something that was toxic. And I feel this is going to lead to kind of like a purification in your life. It's also going to lead to a lot more clarity, I believe. It's like sometimes I do think as well, when we go through a separation or a breakup, that it's like we're not seeing things exactly clearly, right? we're making things out to be better than they actually were in the connection, and then over time we start to realize all the things that were wrong with the connection, right? So I kind of feel that for some of you. I also, you are clearly very focused on work here. Which again, I don't really see a problem with that for you in the first place. I think that it could, whatever you're working on could be bringing you a lot of success, especially in the new year. I think next year is going to feel really good for you. And, maybe it's like one of those things where I think that as the year goes on, it's going to feel better and better and better. And especially at the end of the year, when Pluto finally leaves your sign in November, I think things are going to really feel good. But, at the same time, you should start feeling better just in general energetically soon. So you have this let it go card and this purification card. So it's like letting something go has kind of like purified you in some way. I think it's brought in a lot of clarity into your life. And this clarity, of course, is going to lead to a victory because you have the Ace of Swords here. But you have the Devil, and I do feel that, it's come up for you for months that you dealt with something that was super toxic or whatever the case may be. And it could be anything. It doesn't have to be a person. I do feel like it was a major disappointment. It's like you definitely thought it was going to go a certain way and it didn't. But now I feel that you are again focused on winning, which is a good thing. I think you are focused on maybe having big wins in your life, or maybe you're more focused on creating big wins in your life with the Ace of Swords. And really, that's just how I see it. Ace of Swords is a definite victory and a win in your life. The Ace of Swords can represent a sacrifice or letting something go. And you have this palm frond right here. Palm fronds in the tarot can represent making a sacrifice. This is an olive branch, which can represent an offer of peace, but the olive branch could also represent a new abundance coming in for you. The Ace of Swords, the sword cuts both ways. It's sharp on both sides. So it definitely represents, kind of moving on from one thing, heading towards another. And you have the Lovers. And from the Lovers, look, we go World, Star, Nine of Cups to the Page of Cups. I feel like you think you're going to be disappointed. Oh, sorry, I'm on the wrong camera. So I didn't even show you this bottom row, but I think you think you're going to be disappointed here in this direction because you have the Ace of Cups to the Five of Cups. But really, I think there's something that's going to be very exciting for you coming in, something you've been wishing for with that Star card. This could definitely be love, but again, doesn't have to be. You have the Ace of Swords and Ace of Wands. And the Lovers. Lovers traditionally was a card of being at a crossroads, having a choice to make. And the two aces would represent like a new path or a new direction that you're choosing, something new. And, it seems like everybody is doing this right now. But there's also a lot going on. People always say to me, all you talk about is new. I'm like, yes, exactly. Look, the astrology is very, very clear. Everybody should be doing something new in their life. I don't care what it is. I don't care if you put on a new pair of shoes. It should be something, right? Because that's what the astrology wants. When we work with the energy, we get rewarded, plain and simple. So yes, that I will always continue to talk about new. With the Devil, you have the Knight of Cups. Could definitely be a new connection that's coming in for you. Someone who sweeps you off your feet, who is not like the last person. Again, no matter what direction we take it, you go down to the Star, you go over to the Page of Swords here. Someone definitely has their eye on you, Capricorn. I feel like someone is definitely interested here if you're looking for love, even if you're not. Again, I get plenty of comments. People are like, I'm not looking for love. I'm like, that doesn't mean you're like invisible. Did you turn invisible the second you found a person that you're not looking to love? No, you didn't. So take it as a compliment. With the Ace of Swords, you have the Ten of Swords. Definitely the death of something is going to lead to a victory. This is like a blessing in disguise. I think I kind of feel that's the clarity that you have gained with the Queen of Swords coming up in your present position, basically. I feel like you see that, not having a past person in your life is a blessing. This could also be something else. Like if a business idea or career didn't work out for you, I feel you're kind of like seeing how it's a blessing. With the lovers, you have this Six of Cups. I do feel like a past person is still thinking about you. So, you know, but I would definitely be careful of that. And, you know, I would also say that Six of Cups really does not represent a past person coming back. I know everyone reads it that way, but I feel like it's like one of those cards where like a reader years ago read it that way. Now everybody does. That's not what it represents. If you read any of the tarot books, like Golden Tarot, for example, in that book, it specifically says, do not go back to the past. So, you know, to me, it doesn't represent that. It can represent thinking about the past. It's a card of innocence and nostalgia. It just represents thinking about the past. Doesn't mean that the past is coming back necessarily. So I feel for a lot of you that you're focused on new beginnings anyway. You have the world. World literally represents having a new beginning. We go from the Fool to the World and the Major Arcana, and then we start all over again. So I feel like you're more focused on fresh starts, you know, something new. Next, you have this Jellyfish card. It says, let yourself be seen, transparency. You have this Pearl card. It says, uncovering lost wisdom, hidden knowledge. Yes, since Saturn was in Capricorn back in 2016, I mean, the name of the game for you, Capricorn, is uncovering hidden knowledge, literally. So if you're a Capricorn, if you want to be like rich or successful, or even if you don't want that, if you just want a certain level of success in any area of your life, you know, doing some, digging deep type of, digging for gold energy is where success is going to come from for you. I mean, you know, I basically am a Capricorn, even though I'm not. And, you know, this is all I focus on like every single day after I get done with my videos, you know, work on my other businesses, but I'm constantly doing research, new ways of doing things. And I'm also writing what I'm learning down, which is important. And then I'm also putting it into practice, which is more important. You learn something, then you turn knowledge into wisdom, basically, where you take what you learned, you put it into practice, you double down on the stuff that works, and you get rid of the rest. Plain and simple, literally changed my life. And it's free. Doesn't cost any money to do this. It costs a little bit of time, right? So that's what I would do there. Any area of your life that you want to improve, learn and experiment. You have the Queen of Swords, the Ace of Wands, and the World. The World is a card of achievements, so I feel like you are achieving a lot at this time. Clearly a lot of achievements coming in for you. I mean, you have the Eight of Pentacles, the Star, the Nine of Cups, the Page of Cups. I mean, really, really nice. So, you know, I feel like you're kind of coming out on top. This is also your card, Capricorn, so you show up twice in a very strong position. You have the Ace of Wands. Ace of Wands is a passionate new beginning. Also represents out with the old and with the new. So I feel there's like a new beginning coming in for you. Something that you've been working on behind the scenes with the Eight of Pentacles. So if you've been working on something but haven't really revealed it to the world, I kind of feel this, whatever this is, I'm getting something is going to take off. So maybe you've been working on a business, or you've been preparing your business, or you've been preparing your career, or whatever, you know, whatever it is. And, you know, I feel now it's like getting ready to take off in some way. You have the Queen of Swords, which is, again, seeing clearly. I really do feel you just see a past situation clearly, like a past relationship, a past, past business that didn't work out, something that was toxic. And I feel you're seeing the blessing in what happened. It's like you're finally seeing that, like, okay, this wasn't meant to work out, so you know, it is what it is. You know, the thing is that she has her back to the past, so you know, I really feel you pretty much have your back to things that just are not going to work in your life. With the Queen of Swords, you have the Six of Swords, moving on to calmer shores, moving on to bigger and better things. So you know, I feel like you're really moving on here. I feel like you're not afraid to cut things off now. You know, maybe in the past you were holding on too tightly to things, or you just wouldn't let things go. Now I feel like you're like chopping heads with the Queen of Swords. I feel like you cut things off very quickly now if they're not going to work. Six of Swords is about kind of completely starting fresh. You know, the woman and the child in the boat, they only have the clothing on their back in the Six of Swords. So they kind of represent, you know, completely moving on to calmer shores, moving on to something where maybe they're having a fresh start. And I do feel that for you. With the Ace of Wands, you have the Hangman. Again, just more enlightenment. You know, I wouldn't say we see a lot of enlightenment, but we see enough, because you go here, Hangman to the Knight of the Star. These are both cards of enlightenment. The Hangman is trying to gain enlightenment. The Star can represent enlightenment. So it's almost like you've kind of received answers or clarity for the future, and you know, now you're just kind of moving forward is what I feel here. I feel like you're much more prepared to take action. Like, I feel like you need to get moving. If you've been thinking about starting something new, this type of stuff here is kind of like, okay, time to get to work. There's actually a lot of luck for you, but you need to kind of, you know, start putting things into practice. The Hangman, he needs to get moving. With the World card here, you have the Wheel of Fortune. Yes, taking control. The Wheel of Fortune has been coming up like crazy. I feel it's because we're in a time where we really need to take control of our destiny. You know, the Wheel of Fortune doesn't just happen. You know, we can control the wheel with our vibrations. Also, education. Normally, Aquarius, Scorpio, and Taurus and Leo show up around the card, and they're all holding books. So it kind of says like education is a way that we can take control of our destiny. Also, being at the center of the wheel, you know, things are always going to be spinning around us, good things and bad things, but we take care of the bad things right away and we double down on the good stuff. Exactly what I said. If I were Capricorn, this is what I basically would be doing. And guess what I basically do is I double down on the good stuff, plain and simple. Next in the area of what's coming towards you, you have this Aries card. It says act on it. Yeah, it's time to act. You have this Pallas Athena card. It says think. So I feel stop thinking, start acting is what I feel here. You even have the Eight of Pentacles, which is, you know, a card of apprenticeship, but it's a card of getting to work. So I literally feel it is time for you to get to work, time to get moving here for you, Capricorn. I almost just said Aries. You could also be dealing with an Aries. So if you're looking for love, I do feel there could be an Aries coming in for you. You have the Five of Cups, the Eight of Pentacles, and the Star. The Five of Cups is a card of disappointments. You know, he's crying over the fact that he's lost his taste for wine here, but he's grieving the loss of something that he no longer enjoys. So again, if this is like a person or a place or a thing, you know, that devil, it's almost like this thing was just, you know, I think that it came in a shiny package, but, you know, it's just crap on the inside, basically. So, you know, I feel that what you might be grieving something where it's like what you're grieving is the external, but there's nothing on the inside anyway. You know, it's like a lump of coal, you know, that's maybe covered in gold. So, you know, I kind of feel that here. And, you know, in a lot of ways, though, I feel like you are seeing this. You're turning around. I feel you're more focused on your work anyway. Eight of Pentacles. Eight of Pentacles is about putting work into something. It's a card of apprenticeship and learning, but he's getting to work. So I feel for those of you that have been thinking about getting something started or moving in a new direction, it's time to like keep putting in the work, right? With this card, I feel that that is what's going to lead to the most success for you. I see a lot of like major increase in your finances. Again, Eight of Pentacles to me is material success on the horizon. It says like what you're doing now is going to lead to, you know, income in the future if you're worried about that. You have the Star. The Star is a card of wish fulfillment and, you know, wishes coming in for you. So I definitely feel that. I also feel like you're seeing the big picture. I also feel like you're focused too much on the big picture. You know, it's like I feel like you need to like just focus on what's right in front of you here, especially for those of you that are working on a project. You know, this is saying that I think the big picture can get overwhelming. Just do like what's right in front of you and that will actually help you get started. I also do feel that there is a lot of like kind of recovery energy that I'm getting here. Sorry, I must just drop that whole deck. let's not do that. Let's see. with the Five of Cups, you have the Nine of Swords. Yeah, I would be very careful of this person though, you know. I feel that they probably have their eye on you, but they are probably just going to keep doing the same thing over and over and over again. The Nine of Swords is a card of just repeating mistakes over and over and over again. I would say, especially if you're dealing with a person who repeats mistakes, that you know that they do this, I would be very careful, you know, of that person. You know, because again, I think that they just will always repeat mistakes. It's like they don't learn from the things that they went through. So I, you know, be careful of that. With the Eight of Pentacles, you have the Page of Swords. Yeah, it's like, I feel like someone sees how much work you put into things, you know? So again, if, you know, it's like a person is finally realizing like, oh my God, nobody puts in work into things like Capricorn, right? So I would be careful of this person if this is a past person. I also feel that on like a more positive note, that the Page of Swords has been coming up a lot for a lot of people. You literally have them twice here going this way. Page of Swords is about getting curious. So again, all your success, I'm telling you right now, I promise you, all your success is going to come from digging for gold. Again, I keep encouraging Capricorn, like I would learn as much as you can about whatever it is you do. And this isn't something that should be overwhelming. It's something that you could take, you know, 10 minutes a day. It doesn't take any effort at all to go watch a YouTube video about something that you do in your life and then learn something and try to improve it, like put it into practice. It will change your life. With the Star, you have the Page of Pentacles. I feel like you've been wishing for someone new anyway. I feel like you're getting what you wish for. You have the Nine of Cups here with the Page of Cups. So yeah, there might be a past person who's spying on you, but you know, I feel you've been wishing for something new and there's someone new coming in. Funny enough also, the Page of Pentacles is a card of studiousness. It is the card of learning something new. So again, learning new things will be very important for you. Next, you have this recognition card. It says, you will get the recognition and rewards you deserve. You're not going to get recognized if no one knows who you are. It's time to get to work. It's like you've been in hangman mode, which is like preparation mode. I feel like you've been preparing yourself to put the work into something, Eight of Pentacles, and you have a Star. Like some of you literally could be trying to build a social media or trying to build a following or trying to gain authority in life, right? And this to me says you're getting the recognition. You have this card that says, follow your heart. Following your heart will lead you to the right things. I think we are in a heart-based time, especially for you Earth signs with all that energy in Taurus. I'm telling you right now, it's like Taurus isn't necessarily the heart, but what I would say is that I feel there's an element of heart-based energy with that Uranus and Taurus and Jupiter and Taurus. So I would be doing whatever you can to follow your heart because it is going to lead you to success, plain and simple. You have the Page of Swords, Two of Swords, Nine of Cups, and Page of Cups. I feel like this person is completely the opposite, the exact opposite of this other person. You know, so again, I think you're really attracting, you know, a pearl. You have that pearl card. It's like you're attracting like a diamond type person into your life. It's like, and I feel like it might throw you off at first. You know, maybe this person texts you back right away. You know, maybe the other person didn't text you for days, right? It's kind of like one of those things that I'm getting here where this person actually shows that they want something, but it could throw you off. So again, don't get thrown off. I feel this person is just, they communicate. They actually put in the work. So definitely could be a solid connection coming in for you. I also feel that if you've been hoping or wishing that something can work for you, like in work or business, or if you're trying to become a star or well-known as far as work is concerned, I feel like the work that you're putting into things is actually working is kind of what I'm getting here. You have the Two of Swords. I feel like you're no longer stuck. I feel, you know, again, this is the area of the good stuff. Normally, I'm not a big fan of the Two of Swords, but although I kind of am, you know, I think we're in a time of the Two of Swords where we need to get to this island over here. So it's a card of third place solutions. But, you know, I also feel for a lot of you, this is kind of like saying that I feel like you're no longer, I almost just get an energy of like not trying to fit in, you know? That's more what I get here. It's like you're not afraid to be the fool, right? The fool in the tarot is the contrarian. He's not afraid to, you know, go in his own direction. He's not afraid to do his own thing. And that's what sets him apart. That's why he eventually reaches the world, which is the card of achievement, is because he's willing to go on the fool's journey. And that's kind of like what I get here on the Two of Swords. It's like you're not afraid to, you know, do something in your own way. You have the Page of Swords here. Someone has, I feel like a lot of people actually could be interested in you, could be a past person and a new person. I also feel that embracing your curiosity is the thing that's going to lead to the most success in your life. So, you know, learning as much as you can, you know, exploring new ideas, that's where like all the success is going to come from with that Page of Swords. Let's see. With the Page of Swords, you have the Page of Cups. Yes, definitely a new person has already got their eye on you. You know, it's weird. I don't see anywhere where this person could be showing up in your life. You know, you could be meeting them in public. But, you know, it could be anywhere. It could be through work. It could be anything. But you have the Page of Swords and Page of Cups twice. So I definitely feel it's a person who has their eye on you. With the Two of Swords, you have the Four of Swords. I kind of feel like you're getting a break. You know, the universe could be providing you with a break, or there's just more of that break energy going on here. With the Page of Cups and Nine of Cups, you have the Three of Pentacles. Like I said, a person who actually puts in the work. Three of Pentacles, plain and simple, is the card of teamwork. So this would say to me that, you know, that this is a person who's willing to put in the work, a person who's willing to put in the effort, a person who wants to work on a team. You know, like all that stuff. So love it. I also feel amazing card for getting recognized for the work you do. It's a card of quality work. The guy on the card is being recognized normally by the other two people on the card for the work that he has done. So again, for those of you that are trying to stand out in work and business and career, like whatever it is, you know, I feel that there is, you know, good stuff. I'm smiling because you have this card that says time to act on it. So definitely it's time to act on whatever it is that you've been preparing for. But again, I feel like you're getting recognized for the work you do. You have this wheel. It says indecisiveness, allowing your life to ramble aimlessly. The Eight of Pentacles really is telling me focus. And you have the Queen of Swords as well. But Eight of Pentacles, he's doing focused, diligent work. I've never seen the Eight of Pentacles so much, by the way. I mean, it's been coming up for everyone during the December readings and these weekly readings for this week. So, you know, I would say that it's a time for decisiveness and just putting work out. You have this well. It says family wishes come true. So I feel for a lot of you, if you're hoping to have a family, you could be meeting a person you have a family with, but also could just be good energy with your family. You have this inkpot card. It says problems to be resolved. Don't get like disappointed by like the little things. I think that's the problem right now, is that we could be getting disappointed by tiny little hiccups when they're just hiccups. They're not, you know, anything big or major to worry about. So push through those moments. You have this turkey card. It says someone behaving stupidly. I would be careful of a past person, especially if they're like acting out or doing crazy things or acting stupidly. They definitely could be. You have this purse card that says, pay attention to your finances. I feel like your finances are improving. You know, definitely a time of resourcefulness for Capricorn, but, you know, I think your finances are improving. It's just basically saying, you know, I feel like it's saying don't overspend, don't spend it on things you don't need and all that other good stuff. But this looks amazing. So thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. And definitely enjoy your week.